Hello, everyone. It is Evan here from thetraderisk.com. And in today's video, we're going to be looking at the new watchlist manager in version 23 of TC2000. So at the time of recording this, V23 has just released. It's technically still in beta. And hopefully this video is in a playlist with some other tutorials that we have recorded for you to easily jump around and see some of these new features and enhancements in the latest version. Today's video is all about the new watchlist manager, and the watchlist manager is going to make your life easier navigating across multiple watch lists, but also just moving stocks and organizing stocks that you're interested in a much easier fashion. We're going to show you some of the new features, drag and drop, and then just the selection and checkboxes and symbols that you can now sort of assign to all of your different watch lists. So we're going to jump in that. We're going to keep it specific on the watch list manager in this video. But if you do want to learn more about the platform, check out the playlist we have here and bounce around as you see fit. So without any further, let's get started. All right, we've got TC2000 loaded up here on our desktop, version 23. And before we jump into this watchlist manager, I just want to say for any of you folks who are stumbling across our channel for the first time, thanks for being here first off. TradeRisk, we build cool things for TC2000 users. So our goal is really to enhance the experience for active traders. So if you need custom stock scans or indicators or anything written for this platform or something that you're trying to get a little bit more out of TC2000 out of the box, reach out to us. Let us know what you're looking for. We've helped hundreds, really thousands of traders at this point over the past 10 years, let's call it. And so we want to help you too. Reach out to us. There's a link in the top right. You can start to see some of our products free and paid or in the description of this video. All right, so watchlist manager, brand new feature in version 23, didn't exist prior to this. There's a few ways to pull it up. So first off, if you follow my mouse here, top left, you'll see watch lists. If you click on watch lists, you'll see right here in the top left of this now, it says watch list manager in blue. Click on that and there you go. You've got your new watch list manager. You can expand it and you can see a list of all of the watch lists that you have created in TC2000. I'm gonna click on X. There's another way you can get to it. If you basically just go to any of your open watch lists, whether or not you have scans applied to them or not, and just right click on any of the cells here, and you go all the way to the bottom, you'll see the watch list manager is the very bottom selection. You can open it up there. Or for those of you who are looking to save some time, Control plus M. If you click Control plus M, it'll pop right up here on your screen as well. Now, I'm gonna maximize this. I've got a lot of watch lists built, and some of these are for clients, not all my own, but we've got a long list here. And first thing you're gonna notice is All of your watch list names will be right here in the middle as you've named them. You have this checkbox that is unchecked right now across everything. We're going to talk about that in just a minute. And then we have a count here on the right. So the count is showing you just very simply how many stocks you have within that watch list. And the checkbox here is a very quick way you can add and remove stocks from a watch list. So I'm gonna switch my active. So right now I got Berkshire Hathaway selected. I'm gonna just go to the SPY, S&P 500, okay? And so now, as soon as I moved the primary symbol of my chart to SPY, you can see that a couple of these checkboxes are suddenly checked. And what that's basically saying is your active symbol, in this case SPY, is a component of these watch lists that you see right in here. And so that's helpful. That's easy to know. Okay, I've already got the SPY on these sets of watch lists and I can quickly remove SPY if I want to. If I uncheck any of these, that's gonna automatically remove the SPY symbol from that particular watch list. If I wanna add it to another symbol, for instance, another watch list, for instance, Bitcoin heavy, if we look at this, if I click this right here, SPY is now part of Bitcoin heavy. If I just open this watch list now, you can see it's way at the bottom right here. And let me just click the checkbox off and you can see it just instantly gets removed. So this is a very fast way to just organize everything and see everything at a glance. Let's actually look at modifying these or editing and customizing your watch lists. So you'll actually notice here on the very, very left, I've got this pin on the core. And if I click on this core here and then I go down to edit name or icon. You can see that I first have an option to rename this watch list. So if I want to switch it from core to something else, I can do that here. And you'll also notice that we now have this new image and a color. And so this is new in V23 as well, is where we can assign certain images, icons, to these watch lists to make them easily identifiable. So if you recall, we've had favorites and we've had the flagged symbols in TC2000. So look at all the way to the left here. If you follow my mouse on the US common stocks list here, we've always had these flag symbols that you could easily just add a stock, flag a stock that you were interested in. And so with version 23, what TC2000 is basically, you know, attempting to do is get more watch lists that are easily checkmarked or flagged like you could do in the old previous versions. And so you can first assign this an image, you can assign this a color, and we can just leave this as is for now on our core watch list. And now what we're going to do is I'm going to expand this US common stocks list. There's nothing special about this, it's just the US common stocks list with no filters applied. But I'm going to click on this plus button here, I'm going to add a column, and what I'm going to do is add a tag column. And the tag column is going to bring up all of the watch lists. So I'm going to click on core. And so now what you have here is effectively another flagged column where you can easily have additional watch lists as columns here. And for instance, if I just want to add this to core, well, there it is. I'm going to click on it. It says I can use alt click to check or uncheck a checkbox. So you can't just click on it. You do have to alt click. So as soon as I do that, you can see there's the pin. There's that pin symbol in green that is assigned to core. And I can very quickly, just like I would previously flag, I can add these stocks to this pin. And so if I click on core, I open this watch list, I go down to, or I look for some of these symbols here, see if I see AOS. Yep, there it is right here, MYRG, and whatever else I added, APA is in here as well. It's way up here. All right, so very quickly, if I click that, you can see it disappear, disappear, disappear. Very cool. And so something else I can do is, I'm going to leave this up, is I can click on this. I'm holding the control key down. I'm going to click on this one, this one, this one, this one. And now I can come over here and I can click on a checkbox. Well, there's two things I can do. One, first off, let me just show you this. I can, so what I've done here is I have selected these six stocks. And now if I hold, click and hold and drag, you see how it says add six symbols? I can actually just drop this and add all six of these right to this watch list. So this is that new drag and drop feature. Now I don't want to keep these here. So what I'm gonna do is, yes. So if I go one click, I can get all of them, right? So this is another way to essentially, I can drag and drop, or I can just alt click and you can see all six of them getting added very quickly all at once. So that is a very neat little hack right there. And this is particularly useful. So for instance, if I go down here to this column, so this is another watch list I have with a filter applied to it. In fact, it is one of our premium stock scans on the website. So this is a available stock scan of ours, but it's basically a high volume, strong close stock scan. And so if I close this and I show you just a couple of these stocks as of today, so you can see, you know, big high volume day, strong close, significant move, right? All of these stocks are demonstrating this behavior. And so if this is the scan that I care about, then I can have a tagged column here on the right hand side that perhaps has, you know, swing trade ideas, right? Or you know, high volume breakout candidates for tomorrow. And so I can keep this as a tag here on the right and then just easily kind of push stocks to them and very quickly organize my ideas and then be able to remove them very, very quickly. So this watch list manager pretty much sums up, I think, with that. Basically, navigating stocks, deleting stocks, multiple selection, drag and drop, and then putting these symbols in here. And again, you can put multiple tags together. So you can have, you know, three or four or five different watch lists. If those are the four or five that you use, you have day trading ideas, swing trading ideas, trend following ideas, for instance, and you want tags to always just be a part of your watch lists, then that's going to be an easy way, just like you previously flagged stocks, to just organize and get things where you want them. So I think that's pretty much everything with the new watch list manager. I don't think I left anything out, but if you have any other thoughts, comments, questions, leave them below. And don't forget, we do have a TC2000 email list. So if you want to stay up to date with more of these quick tips, tutorials, foundation series, or new stock scans that we develop, click on either the link in the description of this video, or there should be one in the top right appearing. Jump on our email list. We don't spam anything. Just with new updates is all we share. So hopefully this video was helpful. Check out the playlist for other V23 tips on TC2000, and happy trading.